12 News' Jason Newton is live in Whitefish Bay tonight. And Jason, they were slapped with $3,000 worth of citations.
And police made those citations and the incident report available today. They detail how a local couple told police that they were behind it all, hoping to alleviate some flooding in their neighborhood. Turns out, though, it only made matters worse.
Spelled out in black and white, a pair of $1,500 fines, the offense, exclusion of rainwater.
Maybe these people felt that they were doing something helpful, but it turns out it was the wrong thing to do.
According to police, Michael Payne and Sally Heipel Payne popped a manhole cover at Fairmount and Cumberland, two doors down from Morton Phillips, who had some flood damage of his own.
It's kind of stupid to do that. You've got water that's not running anywhere. You open up the manhole cover and all the water goes down, and where's it going to go because the sewer system was full?
Little did they know it was a sanitary sewer, and rather than flushing the floodwater, it created a real mess in nearby homes. According to investigators, workers on this road project found a sanitary sewer cover dislodged, and those who began pumping sewage out of one home noticed clear water and debris that shouldn't have been present, all pointing to the manhole cover, which one officer reported Heipel Payne admitted to removing with her husband to make the rainwater drain faster.
Just a bad decision, and with hope that that doesn't happen again.
Residents say they want a chronic flooding problem taken care of so that no one is driven to take matters into their own hands.
Now, we did put a call into the village president, but have not heard from her yet. We did read her statement today in that incident report, says that she did get a call from Mr. Payne, who was pretty frustrated about the way that the village has handled flooding in that exact area in the past. We also read about her contact with another resident who had removed a storm drain in another incident in that same area, hoping in that incident also to help alleviate some of the flooding. In Whitefish Bay, Jason Newton, WISN 12 News.